Wait. Wait, wait. Njagala nkulete nga kya magere. Nico. So, tugenda. What should we call our live stream? Do you know about Madhvan Foundation? What? Okay, Madhvan Scholarship. What do you think that suitable title is?
You know about the Madhvan Scholarship?
What you need to know.
And the impact it has caused to the nation.
Hello. Guys, come chat with us. I have a guest today, Madhvan. There is H somewhere.
Yeah. M A D H V A N
I. Hello, good people. Mr. Musinguzi, you are welcome to my live stream. Thank you so much for joining me. And today I'm a little bit late, but nevertheless, I have very important issues to discuss. You know, in Uganda, all our parents, they hustle a lot. They do all it takes. What should I say? If they could go to the Mars and get money to take us to school, they would definitely do that. But on the way, a lot of things happen. Some really push us to where they think it's good for us, or they do all the best they can do for us. Okulabanga tusoma naye olumu nebikwata kintu nga kikwako. Abamu balima, abalala bakola mu government, abalala tebalina mirimu, but they all wish the best for their children. Tewali kisanyusa muzadde nga kutuula wali mu tenti ng'omwana we bamwambazize ekyo. Ekyo bo kye bayita degree. So every parent would want their children to have the best education they have, or to reach the highest level of education they can reach. That is the university. But olumu ebintu bya sente bitutawanya. So abantu abamu ab'emitima emirungi, emitima emiyambi, abaagaliza, abaagala okulaba, because they know a nation is better when it has more educated people, ne bavaayo ne batuyamba. So today njagala twogereko ku Madhvan Scholarships. Do you know that Madhvan gives scholarships? Did you know? The way I nest at campus, I swear I feel like going back to him and telling him, now pay the money I used because I nest so much because I didn't know you. I'm now so privileged to have someone who has benefited from that scheme. And yeah, a lot of my friends are like, we need to know about that. I saw all your questions in my inbox, and I'm going to be asking someone to guide you. But before me, something will be, help me share the live stream so that we can have in a lot more people to come and ask their questions. Maybe you have your siblings at home, they are done, they are in form six, and you don't know what's next. They are in wherever they are, you do not know what's next. Maybe you are stuck. You can't go back, you can't continue because of the financial issues. So you can help me share the stream and let's have a lot more people to come and chat with us. Before I introduce my guest, I need to see more love in the house. Look at sharing this to me. A group. I'm waiting for people to come and then come on. Guys, I'm sharing the stream and I'm welcoming in more people. Come and fire him questions. Where were they when we were nursing with school fees? Why didn't they put vipande mchivuga wana kubitala wane tulaba ntivanei Madhvani avudio tundu kirida. Guys, welcome. Mr. Msinguzi, help me share the stream. Help me share the stream. Just to let me invite you. tubakubuza ibibuzo mwali wanga tubona bane muje tubuze gayo no wa Madhvani atubulire je bali nga tubona abona ne school fees twakaba mwenye kati By the way, take a big heart. Sibuli mgaganda yamba. Take a big heart. I'm sharing the stream. Help me share the stream. Invited more people to come and join me. I'm sharing the stream. Wow. Wow. I'm waiting for more people. Branny Teddy there. I hope you are live. My thing is not updating here. We are updating. We already have one person in the stream and I can't say that. For no more, I should do. We have a guest with us. Come learn, come share, come. Hello from the other side. Hello from the other side. Come share, come let's talk. Come, you can even tell us your education journey, what you went through. Did you know about any scholarships in Uganda? Come and let's share. Let's fire someone questions. It's not all about making them uncomfortable, but it's all about them enlightening the public and a lot of people getting to know about this. Because there are a lot of opportunities out there, but because you're not exposed enough, you will not be able to partake of them. There are a lot of opportunities. Some of you have passed so well. Neto inatomanyitra kuzako kubanga. There is no hope at home. And we can't crucify parents because they have done their best. Ulimzada ya gali zanyo mwanawe kubedo mbuna. So, let's share the live stream. And the title is What You Need to Know. Branny Teddy, help me share this live stream on all the scholars platforms, you know, because a lot of people have their sisters, their brothers, their children, and they are stuck at home. They do not know what to do. They do not know that even such opportunities exist. So today I have someone to tell us about the Madhvan scholarships. They will be introducing themselves. Branny Teddy, help me share the stream to all the groups you have. Tuned. So we have two people in the house and I just saw Madhvan. Welcome. Just kind of sharing the stream. See how many people can come. Come, let's get to know. You don't have to get stuck at home. You don't have. There are a lot of opportunities ready for you, for people like you watching me. Yes, there are a lot of opportunities. So today we are going to be diving into it. First share, we don't want anyone to miss any piece of information that we are going to be talking about. It is very vital, very helpful, and very productive. So we wouldn't want to enjoy alone. I wouldn't want to be successful alone. That's why I definitely brought in this person to help us, enlighten us, and tell us more about these scholarships. Branny Teddy there. William Luyima, you are welcome to my live stream. Lero bade njaga tuogere ku haso zetu yita munga tusoma bane school fees zibula zitu ya 10 ampya bazade batunze ebibanja batunze plots batunze na mayumba na masefuri abaga tunda kusomesa bana. But then if there are opportunities like scholarships, like foundations that sponsor people who have maybe performed very well, maybe depending on the categories, they have the person I'm hosting today has a big hand. No, he'll introduce himself. He knows better about the Madhvan scholarships because he himself, he has benefited. So William Luima, webale kubeda nage, thank you for joining me. With school fees, is that for KBMP? Mwali muina wo, oba mwali mweya. Chari chitie wamu. Chari chitie wamu. I am sharing the live stream. William Nyambako or sharing it abantu bonna as I'm going to invite my guest in just a few seconds. Of tiki tiki butono ndina mukububala. I'll be inviting him. I invited him all the way from the east to come and chat with us about this. So please come and fire him with questions. Let's share the stream so that a lot of people can benefit. Chemanya bantu bangi. Teri chibonya bonya bazadde nga school fees bana bantu bangi. Mubawulira mu taxi nga bagamba bana banywa bananywa obuji. Ngolo sente zonna batute kusomero. Mujje. Ndi kusharing a stream eno. Mujje mutubuze ebibuzo. What do you need to know about the Madhvan scholarship? Groups, all the groups with us, tuli sharing a stream so that tulabanti information etuka ku bantu bangi. I swear the chenaita munga nsuma sagala muntu yenna akiyitemu, sagala muntu yenna akitesting eko, because nothing frustrates a student naddala omuntu nga ayagala okusoma by the situation nga tewali sente bannanga owulira nga n'ensi yonna nga Africa yenna etudde kugwa omuntu omu gwagisitudde ku bibagabega byo. So you are welcome. Tugenda tandika nga wetulinda n'abantu abalala bajje. Meanwhile, let's just get to know my friend, because me, I know him, he's a good friend of mine. So all of you, I would like you to be in the know of who he is. Come get closer here. You are welcome to my channel.
Thank you, Erinah.
Guys, he is a ninja. He is a bright guy. You see him, don't be deceived by his look. He's not a boy, he's a man. And he's so informed about whatever he's going to be sharing with us. Share the stream so that a lot of people can benefit. My account is showing me two people in the house. I know more of you are watching me, and we are set to let you know all the things you need to know about the Madhvan scholarships. First, tell me. Introduce yourself to my people.
Wow, guys, and all those people who are on live stream, we are perfect and we are live.
Yeah.
And we are here to speak about Madhvan scholarship. Would you know that Madhvan scholarship sponsors are thousands of students?
Thousands?
Thousands
where
of
does
students.
He get all that money?
Wow, we shall need to know where he gets the money. But well, I'm called Nicholas. I'm being sponsored by Madhvan, finished my degree 4 years. And I'm now working with Madhvan, that is African Packaging Ginger. I traveled all the way to come and be interviewed by
just Erinah. To know, we surmised. Let me not use big English. Twa guessing, auntie. A lot of people suffer with school fees. So I'm like, why don't you come to Kampala? I asked you about Madhvan scholarships. A lot of people can benefit from it. He himself is a product of the Madhvan scholarship. So bobo inayo mwana yena ewaka oba ali mu senior 6 oba asoma, you tune in and let us get to learn more about it, because me, honestly, I suffered, I niched because I didn't know about it. So Nico, thank you for honoring my invitation. And he's a good guy. Just know he traveled in all the way from Ginger to come and be here and share this information with us. I thought of using StreamYard, but I was not well versed with it. So I'm like, let's kill a day and come and chat with me, okay? Guys, share the stream to all your sisters, all your brothers, and let's get into this. So,
yes.
Let me ask you, how did you get to know about the scholarships?
Wow.
Some of you, it is even the rich who are gifted with information that is supposed to help other people. I'm not telling you that this gentleman is rich. I see babes, we are all like, okay, come with the kid. I'll not give you a contact, but he's doing well, though. So how did you get to know about the Madhvan scholarship?
How did I get to know about the Madhvan scholarship? One, it started in my year one. My journey wasn't easy. I never had tuition when I was joining university.
But was all well before you started university?
All wasn't well. It was a little bit hard. Yeah, life was a little bit hard, but thank God he enabled me to get that scholarship. How did I know this scholarship? You see, there's when semester one became hard, and my life, we had a disagreement with my auntie, and my auntie told me, Nicholas, go back to the village. Me, I don't have tuition. I said, God, me, I'm not going back to
the
village.
Was she the one taking care of you?
Yeah, she was the one taking care of me.
Wow.
But I told God that I'm not going back to the village. And when I told God I'm not going, I stayed with a friend. Life became a little bit hard. We tried to push on with life, but with God, everything is possible. Erinah.
Yeah, nothing fails. God.
Nothing fails. So that semester, I was struggling. That was semester two. Semester one, my auntie paid my tuition. Semester two, I was struggling.
And they already introduced into the campus.
testing that achieve a degree.
Yes.
Chamakulu. So when I realized that the product of the degree is
valuable.
So I stayed with my friend of mine. So in the meantime of staying with my friend of mine, as a brilliant guy, I had many friends.
Yeah.
So many friends started inducing me, like, Nicholas, will you can apply for an available scholarship? I decided to go for loan scheme, but the process was too late for me.
Very long, even.
Then I decided to go for African Development Bank scholarship. The process was also a little bit, they favored more of ladies. my friends, all the ladies got the scholarship.
Sure.
So I'm like, wow, what next for me? I had a friend who was working with Madhvan. By then, if I don't forget his name, he's called Akim. He's working with now the U.S. Embassy.
Wow.
This friend of mine induces me to...
So you guys, Madhvan is sending people to posh places, U.S. Embassy. Do you have his name?
Yeah, I do. We have friends in the U.S.
Shall link up?
We have doctors in Germany. So wow. Madhvan has sent very big people outside there in the field.
Okay.
So this friend of mine introduces me to this scholarship. He says, no, you can apply. This scholarship starts after first year of study, when you have a good grades.
Oh,
so
it's not that immediate from senior six.
No.
Ogenda campus because those singers you call it out. Ogovudem senior six ogenda ku campus. J Max, thank you for being here to recoup, enlightening the people about the opportunities out there so that people don't miss out. Omwami ono gwendi na ye ambassador wa Madhvan scholarships. So if you can share this stream, it can help a lot of people. Please share, we shall appreciate it. Okay?
So I was still explaining. So this friend of mine introduced me. Madhvan, the scholarship. I'll take you through the requirements of the scholarship, how you join the scholarship.
Yeah.
A scholarship, one of its role and one of its requirements, you should be one who has finished at least first year of study.
Okay.
One who is already admitted to any of the public universities in Uganda.
Of course.
One who has a good grade. In your first year.
What do you mean by good? Because
good grade.
Two good demo VR. Because there is A, B, and C, D maybe. Nga guafunye C, go wakari. Katibu gamba good, basi kutegi.
By the way, Erinah, wubodu
ya mweri chimu madivani.
Wubodu realize nzembo, omwana avamu chale. Nga afunye C, afunye E. Kwa hiyo watuka ku campus. You would find that here, like, from the A's, the B plus.
Ngolabari, nabitunza bakulashi. Baba, jaku isa vivuru.
Aotoja kuntu align that angle, kanjinele kumadivan. So, kati, requirement, here, good grade number 2.2 and above. The requirement here.
Okay.
2.2 is a teziva nzimu.
Teziva nzimu.
So, it's 2.2 and above. Wubo ina 2.2 and above, you finish your first year of study. Nenze nasinyikinga. Then I ingida munga ndi nakamala only semester two. Ngandina only results the semester one. Gateba gala full year.
Zibate zina fuluma, yes.
Zibate zina fuluma because of that process. So now because it's a first year semester one results.
But on the Sula.
So when I'd used the first year, first semester results, then applying and then I'm applying a semester two.
Oh, Romontono wakugama Madhvani Jerry. Tubuli the offices that were zisangibwa wa applying it away.
Aha, ne number ku offices awe. Oh, first number yampe number. Admin's number call up scholarship. I'm into Mrs. Bitu Sapoto.
Okay.
Ya pia admin wa scholarship. Nampe namba ine mukubira nenga mami, you know what? I'm struggling in tuition. I want this scholarship. They have told me about it. My friend Akim has told me about it. So all of the process, Madam Beatrice na kola shi, nampa support. Nangamba you can make it. Ate sure. Being an orphan, nari mfiridwa yeyo msajia, the one who was educating me. The one who was educating me. I lost my dad in 2003.
Wow,
has left with my poor mom, who can't facilitate for me at
and
university.
You have dreams, you have visions.
I had dreams never to give up in life and to continue persisting. So, Erin, I tell you what, the lady supports me, she helps me. She'd be like, Nicholas, no, you can use the first year's semester one testimonial. I'm like, wow. And that first year's testimonial, I had the first class. So, wow. In that process, I applied, I attached all the requirements. Of course, it takes, I'll go through, guys, the courses it takes.
Yes.
And in that first semester, I had good grades. Attach all the requirements. I went on net. I downloaded there. For I didn't visit the offices.
You didn't go to the offices?
No.
So it is both physical and online.
Physical online.
This is wonderful. Please, if you have anyone who is in first year struggling with tuition, let them tune in and let them get to know, because this scholarship works after first year, not direct from senior six then as you're entering the university, but as you finish your first year from his explanations, then you can be eligible to start the what? The scholarship. Peter Kalmukama, thank you for being here with us. Mushota Shinde, thank you for coming. We are here trying to pass on the opportunities to let people know that there is a scholarship that can help you. Do not drop out after your first year because things are tough. Here is the brand ambassador from Madhvan Scholarships to enlighten us. How can you apply? What should you do? What do they need? He's telling us about his story. He had lost his support system, his grandfather, his father. Guys, inviting more people, let's fire him questions. I appreciate you for being here. So, you're online. Internet yet we are giving na internet. Mpasasila muigo ko za internet. Opportunities nyingi ziri ko internet. Na yete mumani. Omiya itagenze na ku office. Abalumbye ku internet. Kategori yao ina smartphone because it's just one of one. Safi.
Yes. The lady helps me. I apply. After applying, you see God's grace. When you apply, you leave everything in the hands of God through prayer. So I applied, and after applying, and I was shortlisted for the interview.
Wow.
And I'm like, interviews. Yes. You know why they carry out interviews?
Why? But they
they want to screen out someone. There are many who have applied. This scholarship is 700 million.
What?
Ugandan money.
Per year?
Per year. 700 million Ugandan money.
Guys, this you can...
applied for the scholarship.
How do you get to know that someone is on government
school?
Do you go through all that data? Bana Uganda baya yofunye government. You know, tuleke abana abalane bafuna.
So you'd find someone is on African Development Bank, he's sneaking at the same time on Madhvan scholarship. Why do they always do so? They want to eat the tuition. They want to balance their, you know, campuses are very wise. So that's why they do the screening. And they want also bright brains. Brains that are orphans, but they can sustain and add value to this nation.
Yes.
You might be coming from a rich family, yet there's someone poor. So why would you limit the chance of someone who is poor?
But
yet
you can.
Of course, bus screening. So in your interview process, they will let you know that, Erinah, you know what? You're from a rich family.
Sure.
Yes, they can. They can. They can, but the opportunities are always there.
There are people who are from rich families, but they are not supportive.
Now let me give you a good example of that. You may be from a rich family, but you've lost your parents, and you're staying with your aunties who are mistreating you, who are not meeting your university target, why would Madhvan come in and help you? Even if you come, your aunt drives Mercedes-Benz or what? Madhvan can come in and help you because it knows you're poor. You know how stepmoms are. You know how aunties are. Yeah, I'm a living testimony of my own auntie. She rejected me.
Maybe she got
stuck. She sleeps in a mansion house.
She got stuck. I'll be here for Nicholas.
So that is it. So I did. I went for screening. They do screening at Makerere University. They publicize this thing in the newspapers. They put a PDF on their website. You will eventually know that the list is out.
Okay.
So in the process of checking Erinah, I find my name first on the engineering courses.
Wow.
I celebrated. I first made some now.
There are a lot of universities in Uganda, a lot of courses in those universities in Uganda. So we would like to know, because some of you may be excited, oh, me, I'm doing tourism, I'm doing leisure management. Am I eligible for these courses? We need to know, what categories do they cater for? Do they go to all universities? Do you know Tim University in Uganda? Do you know Muni University? Do you know Mbarara University? So does it cater for both government and private universities? And which kind of courses are covered in these scholarships? Spring Garden is here. He's saying good morning because he's from Jamaica. It is morning in Jamaica. So Spring Garden, we are here trying to pass out an opportunity of scholarships in Uganda to people who are less privileged. He is a brand ambassador of one of the biggest scholarships. And a beneficiary from one of the biggest scholarship schemes in Uganda. So I brought him to share his story. He is an orphan. He was stranded, didn't know what to do with, yet he wanted to accomplish his education. Come and listen to his story as he's also sharing the table of opportunities that is there for other people. Thank you for joining us. Oh, you are in USA now. Thank you for joining us. If you can share this stream to any Ugandan you know or your friends, let's listen and enjoy and learn from his story. So which kinds of universities does this scholarship scheme cover? What's private and government and which courses?
This Madhvan scholarship covers a variety of universities. It covers all public and partners with some
private.
It covers, let me count them. It covers Makerere University.
Okay,
it covers Chambogo University.
In Wakiso.
It covers Mbarara University.
Yes, in Mbarara.
It covers Mobs University.
Yes.
It covers Sitema University.
Wow, Tororo.
It covers Ndeje University. And it partners with other private universities, KIU, Kampala International University.
Is it only universities or even other tertiary institutions? Like vocational institutions?
They have now put up a second scholarship. It's sponsored by Kakira. That one caters for all vocation. Every person doing diploma, certificate, and diploma, certificates, and you are in institutes, it caters for that. That is worth $200 million.
Okay, so for this Madhvan main, is for bachelor's only?
Bachelor's.
Okay, so tell us which courses they cover.
Wow, Madhvan.
Someone may be doing makeup and cosmetics, tailoring.
Wow, Madhvan covers most, especially a variety, but one of most of the courses are science courses.
Science.
Are you
courses.
Doing engineering?
Okay.
Are you doing medicine and surgery? Are you doing pharmacy? Are you doing lands? Are you doing civil? Are you doing accounting and finance? Are you doing, okay, the others, because it partners with business, that's well-known like MOOCs.
MOOCs, yeah.
And other KIU. It partners in other areas, those are the other scholarships as well. It does also, I think, business administration,
okay.
Business admin, law at Makerere.
I've not heard, there is a big private university I've not heard. The Islamic University of Uganda, IUIU. Is it covered under
yes.
the scheme? Wow, guy, do not miss the opportunity. Thank you, Spring Garden. He has just shared this conversation to his community tab so that a lot of people can see this information. So let him take us through that all we need to know. He has a wonderful story. He has gone through a lot as a young man, and his story is so inspiring. We are now at a point where he finds hope in a scholarship scheme. So tell us.
Where I find hope in this scholarship scheme.
Yeah, so you find your courses under some of the courses. Did you know about this before you applied in this scholarship scheme?
Yes, being one who initiated me in the scheme, being
briefed
an engineer.
Yeah.
In the Madhvan company, me, I said, you are doing engineering, and I applied eventually.
Okay.
And when I applied, I went to the interviews. Mm. We were very many Erinah. If you don't put down on your knees and pray to God.
Did you think you would really get? I mean,
with my faith, with my burning faith, with my results,
and with
my
past.
Orphanage. I said, God, this one is in for me. Because Erinah, I cried in semester 2 when I was writing
but
papers.
I used to see you a jolly guy. I was in the same university with this man. I was ahead of him by 1 year. But all that he's telling me is just being news now. Sharon is in Turkey. She's a Ugandan. Thank you for watching us. Share this information to every Ugandan you know. Anyone in year one who can partake of these scholarships. Nico is sharing his stories of how he got to know this. I used to see him in the university. He's a jolly man. He's a friend to everyone. He smiles a lot. He is a leader. He's very ambitious. He's just telling me that he was suffering in that period of time I got to know him. I didn't know about that. How did you manage to hide all your poverty, misery, and your pain?
How I managed to do that? You see, the Bible says when you publicize everything of your problems to anyone, doesn't mean that everyone is happy.
Yes, and not everyone is going to
not everyone is going to be passionate and help you. So I would cry in my car room.
My God.
I would go in my hostel in my car room. I cry to my God. I cry. Read my Bible. So when I'm out and we're with you, I'm
you
in the
smile.
Committee of leader, I'm the general secretary, yes. And I'm serving very well.
Yes.
And there's no problem. But that's the reality. You cry to only your God, because it's only God who knows how to answer your problem.
I understand. Wow. We thank God that he showed this. There is light at every end of the tunnel. Uh-huh. So Ofunyi, you're shortlisted.
So I'm shortlisted. I go for the interview, and in the interview I felt a panel. There are Africans on the panel. There was two big men from the Indian scholarship, that is CK Insulin Club. That man is the secretary of that scholarship. By the way, this scholarship is headed by my boss. I will appreciate for the support he has given to us, and that is Ronnie Madhvani.
Okay.
The son to the Madhvani and heads this scholarship.
Okay.
I'm sure when he watches this video, he will be inspired.
Amen. We thank you, Ronnie, for being such a wonderful man. Thank you.
So, Erinah, I go for the interview. I meet a panel of 7. An interview is a normal thing.
Yeah.
You expect lively questions. How is your performance? And they will beat you very well. There are some people who bring papers from NASA Road. You find they ask, what did you get in English in prison? And the fellow doesn't know.
Oh my God.
And then the fellow will be like, I got credit from her in reality. You got an F9.
Oh my God. Why would people go do that?
So I go to this interview. It's a normal one. You interact with them. You tell them your story. They screen out your documents. Are they the real ones? They check, have you submitted the necessities that are needed? They ask you normal questions, how have you been managed to survive in the last 1 semester or 2 semesters?
So you have a chance to tell a bit of your story.
A little bit of your story. You have a chance to tell them that, this tuition money, this semester I nashed. I
hope
didn't
you didn't
write.
Cry for them.
No,
they may awaken all the pain you've gone through
in the previous
year.
A pain is something that when you speak, somebody feels it. The one I'm talking and you'll be like, hey, you're shocked.
Yeah.
Like, I worked with you as a leader, but the story I didn't know. So that is it. When you speak, somebody will just feel your pain. You don't need to cry. Because me, I don't cry. I rarely cry in public. So I go for the interview. I finish my interview. I sit home back. I do my internship. By then it was holiday. I do my internship. I sit home. I relax. Wait for that right time. The right time comes and they publicize the names in the newspaper.
How long did they take?
It doesn't take long, something like 2 to 3 months. When the semester has started,
yes.
College, semester one. When that semester started, that's when the list always comes out. And it comes out, if semester starts in August, then the list is going to come out around when we are clocking to August.
Okay, June?
July, end of July there. That's when the final list comes out. When the list comes out, you go on the net, you download the PDF on their website. You check the newspapers, if you have access to the newspaper.
They even publicize in newspapers?
They do so.
Wow.
Because it's recognized by government. When they are launching the scholarship, the Minister of Education all of them are always around and they be around during the launch of the scholarship. Students who have benefited, they are there. When they are making the advertisement, they use our faces.
Yeah, I used to think they even just see. I didn't know they go through all these interviews. I used to sit back there and be like, hey, these scholarships, I think they take people they know. Maybe these people keep on fixing in their own people.
No, they
so
don't.
I didn't know they really go through all this kind of hassle, interviews, questions and all that. It is a real hassle.
Yeah, it's a real hassle.
So it is genuine.
Yeah, it's a genuine one. It's prayer. The way we apply for government, you do for a job, you pay some money, but it's what you don't pay.
Don't pay a single
You get
point.
The form, fill the requirement, put God first. You submit your form and then the rest you leave in the hands of God to do the rest.
Mm.
So I finished the interview and I check in the PDF, I downloaded, my name was there.
Wow.
And I make a very big loud noise.
I want to know that reaction. Where were you?
I was in Chireka here in the Kav village with my uncle.
Okay.
And a colleague of mine called me. I was just home resting, watching TV. Colleague of mine calls me, Nicholas, you know what? The list is out.
Wow.
Go to the PDF and download.
Your heart started pumping.
I first told uncle, you know what? First, pray for this phone for a miracle to happen. Uncle is like, what is that going to happen? I applied for a scholarship. They have told me the final list is out. And I first go down, I kneel. And then I pray. After praying, I download the PDF. Downloading the Kapidia. Oh wow, I find my name there amongst the Chambogo engineering students.
How many people were given in total in your
year? In our year at the university or
university.
The whole country? University, you were around 50.
In one university
my year,
like this?
One university.
So this thing is genuine?
Very genuine.
I used to think these things are fake.
Oh,
honestly.
Very genuine.
I am so sorry. I had lost. You know, people have suffered a lot and they have lost hope. There is where I went, like for this State House scholarships. Our year they told us State House no longer gives scholarships. But when I joined in year one, I was with fellows who had scholarships. I was like, where did these ones get them? The person told us, those things were closed 3 years back. So I'm shocked yours is a genuine. Wow. How does uncle react?
Uncle, I make a loud noise as if someone was running crazy. Because I have been yearning for this thing. I can't tell you the story of how I sneaked to write papers, but you can't believe I wrote semester 2 papers without paying any coin.
Without in the university?
With all the disturbances.
I know.
With all entering math, you know math 2? You enter math 2 3 hours and you only enter 2 hours. The rest is history.
I understand.
My sister.
I've ever done that.
The rest
you should
is just
sit me down, I tell you my story.
So I do these papers, I do the house, so I went there. Finally, came hiring crazy. I made the noise, I made the whole environment know that God has done something in the house. So I get my scholarship and I go and pick my form when the semester started. My acknowledgement letter.
Yes.
That shows that you have gotten the scholarship. So I pick it. The rest, I start from there.
Wow.
Now, as I start from there,
did you
I become
it?
A leader in this college.
How do you? You've just joined. There are people who have been there for years.
I joined. Madhvan has an association at the university. Though
yeah.
It wasn't sounding.
For all his students.
For all the students. Because there are some who are already there. For us, we are just new entrants. We call ourselves new entrants.
Yes.
But those who are in year 3, those who are in year 4, those are old entrants. Those who are still existing in this college.
Yeah.
So I started the process. I joined the association. By then it was spearheaded by a lady called Valeria and somebody working with Madhvan. Now it has an office at the Madhvan main office. It's called Bernard. Wembale Bernard. He was in your year?
Bernard.
Wembale Bernard. He was doing environmental. So I joined the association and the rest is just how I maneuvered and
You're such a vigorous man. You've just gotten the scholarship. Now you want to lead
leadership.
People you found.
Yes. By then I was in year 2.
Okay.
I joined the association because, of course, I was serving in Chumesa as a general secretary.
Chumesa, it was the Chambogo University Mechanical Engineers Association, and he was serving us as a secretary as I was serving as a chief whip. I know you don't know a lot about me, but I'll do a video about that. He was a very diligent man, and someone is saying something to you. Great vibes. I would like to thank this brother for his interest in and in this feedback on the Madhvan Foundation, big up.
Wow, thank you. She's called Peter Carl. Thank you so much, Peter Carl.
Yes, he's not afraid to share his story because he knows a lot of people can benefit from it. So,
so I become the new entrance leader.
Wow.
Leading a team of 50.
The 50 people, yes.
Yeah. So I become a new entrance leader, and we start inducing, working with the current leadership. Mm-hmm. We start making more public health. In entire the university gets to know about.
About the school. Me personally, I didn't know about.
You didn't know?
Yes.
You didn't know, but when I became other posts, it was sounding and well, have products, by the way. Yeah, well, people have gone through my hands. There are very
so
you've many,
guided people.
Very many.
And they have gotten this quality.
Very many. Very many. And so I'm willing to guide anyone out there.
Okay.
Who wants the support?
Is it okay for us to share your number after the screen? Okay, so did you tell this auntie of yours who told you to go back?
No, I did not.
Why?
I did not.
At least she brought you to the city, she showed you the light.
Now, why I didn't induce my auntie to this, because I used to interact with elderly people, those mm-hmm. are my friends,
mm.
and they would tell me, don't tell your auntie. You never know the plans. Why would she wish you to go to the village? That means you never wish for a bright future. So don't tell her. You will tell her after graduating.
So those are people who advised you. Uh-huh.
So I didn't tell her. I think we started interacting after graduating.
Sure. So you're in good terms now?
Yeah.
So tell us, what does the scholarship cover?
The scholarship covers full
for
tuition.
Example?
Like me, I was paying 1 million and 50,000, and he would pay all the money.
That is in only in the second semester. First semester is like 1.7.
Ah, now I'm coming to that. So it covers only tuition. That is 1.50. This scholarship covers the tuition, and now that is first semester. There is others for us in here. We used to pay 1.9. There.
Around there, 2 million, yeah. Sometimes just 1.8,
yeah.
1.9.
Yeah.
So
now, the rest functional fees, you're supposed to try out yourself.
Oh.
And me, when I became the general secretary of Chambogo University, Madhvan Sponsored Students Association, what I fought for is us who can't raise this money, are we legal to write papers? I entered the vice chancellor's office.
Wow.
I entered the Deputy Vice Chancellor of Finance.
You have
yes.
guts.
Yes. I entered convincing them how we can help.
Knowing that it's not you alone.
Because I was part of it, I knew I would not raise that money.
Yes.
So I would stand in for the rest.
Mm.
I would speak
as
for those
also
who can
rescuing
speak, as I'm rescuing myself.
Wow.
So the step I took, I met the Vice Chancellor. Mm. That's Captain El Katunguka, the current one.
Mm.
I told him, sir, we have a challenge here. Madhvan, to pay your check or to pay your tuition, you must be someone who has submitted a testimony of the previous semester.
Yeah.
Why do they do so? They eliminate the tax. We are hardworking. That's why we have people in the U.S.
So
we
there
have
is
Martin
no
Morgan
relaxing,
in the U.S.
No,
there's
relaxing. Once you get a retake, you're
hardworking. Mm-hmm. I retake the steps are there. I'll discuss about the tech if you want.
Okay.
But you submit the testimonial. Mm. The testimonial shouldn't have to return.
Mm-hmm.
Because hardworking people, we have people who have impacted to this nation.
Yes.
We have Martin Mugans is in the U.S. We have Dr. Richard, the current chairman alumni. He works with German and all most of his time is outside the country.
Wow.
We have farmer. We have many people who have impacted to this
so
nation.
You have big examples. There is no room for it.
Yeah. So hardworking people. If you have a retake there, of course a retake is something unavoidable. It can be avoidable because someone can fall sick.
Mm.
Someone can lose mom. Paper. Mm. He has a paper on Monday, he has lost mom on Monday. You know how you mentally get tortured?
Yes.
So it causes a retake. So if you have a retake, you generally write what caused that retake.
Okay.
You attach the medical. If it was burial, you attach the death certificate. And some of even you let the lady, the admin,
the one in charge.
Do you know that you have lost my mom?
Okay.
You'll be reconsidered during that time.
Okay.
But if you're unserious, you don't have this genuine reason, my friend, you're eliminated.
You're off. But you're why off. Would someone, with all the suffering, you went in before you got an opportunity, why would you not be serious? Why would you not be grateful for the chance you have and you use it? Why would you put it to waste, yet you know a lot of people don't have it? So, tell us. So you're covering tuition.
It's covering only tuition. Mm-hmm. So I stormed Vice Chancellor Katunga's office. I convinced him that we need always to get provision exam cards. We don't need to wait for checks to come because Chambogo, you know, our university results are coming. You have people on Monday, results coming on Friday. When will you process for you?
Yes.
Eric Katunguka reconsiders me, reconsidered my letter, reconsiders my view.
Thank you, sir.
And he helped me. He sent me to the Deputy Vice Chancellor of Finance. He's currently there that month. I talked to him.
I've reached all those offices, wow, by the way.
And everything is okay.
With my own story.
And everything is okay. I started, now we were given authority to do papers using provisional examination cards. No, without even paying. So here comes the rule. You must sit papers over. You have balances. Well, you don't have balances.
Wow.
That was my initiative.
That is wonderful. That is wonderful.
So me, I write.
Do you know how many people you helped?
They were
because
me.
A lot of my ninjas had dead years because of maybe this part of tuition, this part of thing. Wow. Thank you.
Wow. So I do that and we write papers. Now, me, I finish 4 years when I have a debt of 4 million.
In 4 years?
Yes. I have a debt of 4 million.
Where would you get it?
That's the answer.
What is mom doing in the village?
No. Mom dies. Mom dies in 2017 when I'm going to do my finals. Then when I'm in fourth year.
Guys, things happen. This was, as in, you're in your final year.
Yeah, mom dies.
You lost your mom, you lost your support, and she's now the only remaining support system you have. Probably she's, every time you're down, she's, because me, what, every time I was down, I would look up to my parents, I would like to make them happy. Now your only hope, for now, it's gone. Where do you get the courage to move on, to push on?
I like that question, and you approach it.
Yes.
Now, where do I get the guts to move on?
Yes.
Life was a bit hard, eh?
Yeah.
Life was a little bit hard, but, and I tell you this, through God, through prayer, through faith, you always achieve.
Amen.
The best.
Wow.
So, when I lost mom, I just lost memory. Yeah, lost memory. And
it affected you
immensely.
Yeah,
it affected me, because she was my everything. I lost the rest, I lost the grandfather, I lost the dad. So I never had someone to be there for me.
Yeah.
So now I lost memory. I was treated as a treatment for 1 full month.
A month?
Yes. I'm not at campus. But I come back and I do a miracle.
There is a time he got lost from campus and then they told us, this is now, I'm telling you this life. Of course, I met him when he had just come back. I was like, oh, they told us you're sick. How are you feeling now? We didn't know that all these things had happened. Me personally, this gentleman, I was serving on the same cabinet with him. He doesn't even tell me that he lost a mom. He's someone who keeps things to himself, I should say. So someone told us in your absentia, I'm saying this now, that you had run mad. I'm sorry. That they had bewitched him. That he had run mad. That is all I got to know. I just kept quiet. I didn't want to tell you. Maybe it would offend you. I didn't know how you would react.
Now I'm answering it. I lost
did
memory.
Did you run mad?
No, not really. You see, that trauma.
I know. I can't imagine.
So that trauma when you've lost someone.
Your support, your only hope.
Yeah, your only hope, because even if she wouldn't support you financially, she would support you
emotionally.
The advice she would give you, she would be like, Nico, do ABC. Nico, do ABC. So I lost memory. That's the reality. But I recovered, and when I came back, I was fired. I'm the only guy who scored 100% in the field. You had never known.
100%.
That is engineering mechanical design taught by Professor
Park Yongang from Korea.
So I come back from 1 month off campus and I score 100%.
So this statement is true. They say if you want to shoot further, this is it called a kata what? Kanaka botide kuba obunyonyi. Boba yagala kuba walusoka noza kema vega, then you know that's when it can go far. I'm seeing that is what exactly happened to you. This old trauma was setting you ablaze for something big.
So I come back, I read.
Where do you get this strength? to come prayer. Back with such fire and vigor.
Prayer. That's a reality. Even when I was in the hospital, I had my red Bible. That red Bible was given to him by the grandfather.
That one who passed away.
Yeah. I used to read it for him. Because he told me, Nicholas, people will fight for land, but have this. Have this. I even have it up to now. And I read that same red Bible. I used to read it for him before he died. You know what they say, that the word of God doesn't perish.
It doesn't perish, yes. So heavens and earth may pass away, but the word.
I pray so much. I fast. I used to attend overnight. I'm at Madame Beatrice's Church Living World Assembly. I'm in Kakumba, but of course in Kakumba was a leader as well.
You man.
I serve.
How many posts do you have? It was everywhere, like MTN.
So in my final...
Viva, thank you. They are saying good job. He did so great. He's now here to educate us more about the Madhvan scholarships. Thank you, Habib. If you have anyone who is in year one and is struggling with tuition, they can tap this jazz. They can even check me out and they rewatch this video. It will be so helpful to them. I'm chatting with a young man who is the brand ambassador and the beneficiary from these scholarships. They are real. Temuli biabi no makona chubana baba gundi ababa nene temuli baba nene na baba tono abana bonna abali eligible obo inebisanizo ofuna scholarships. So tulikuulira story atunyumiza mutu wa yamunaye ngabo tumuyigira ko biche bimuzamu amanyi his lowest points and his greatest hope. Thank you for joining us, Habib. Okomyewo sebu.
I read so much, I pray so much, I attend overnight, and overnight stand the miracle paying the 4 million. When I recovered from that trauma.
Did manna fall from heaven like manna fell for Israelites when they came out of Egypt? We want to know. Truckers is from America and he's running.
All right. When I come back, I attend overnight. I was invited by the admin. Scholarship. She's called Beatrice Apoto.
Okay.
She invites me in her church.
That means you're relating so well with these people. If they know you personally, if they can invite you for their personal growth, you are relating so well with people.
Yeah, as a leader.
Guys, you need social capital. Don't look at money. Sometimes all you need is not money, but you need to know someone who knows someone. Or you need to know someone who is somewhere. Okay? Not only social capital. Okay?
Yeah, so of course by then I was the president. During that podcast, I was the president of Chambogo University Madhvan Supporters Association. So, of course, I had to interact with those other people in the office.
Those big people.
So, they knew me from the inside part and the outside part.
Let me ask you, we are seeing them supporting your tuition. You're in school because that's your biggest dream. How could you handle these other costs of being at campus besides the functional fees where you have a day? These things of feeding, accommodation, work, printing work, do they buy for you work?
And now printing work, I'll start with that one. That one I used to do summaries and I sell them. People would buy my summaries. My summaries had to succeed. My summaries had to succeed. People would buy my summaries. That's where I would get money to buy handout. People would just buy from your handout.
They say you read your tubuli.
I did 3 projects, you can't believe that. And I was paid money for that. I did 2 projects for my friends. And they even warned me.
He knew where he was coming from. He has lost all his support system, his grandpa, his father, and his mother in his final year at campus. Who was his only left hope? Now he comes back, he even first gets a trauma, he's affected for a month, he's not at university. We were told at university that he had run mad, but he's telling us it was just a trauma. He comes back, like he shoots sharper than the people who were there. Guy, he got a brain, he got God, I think God sleeps in his room. So, tell us.
Uh-huh. Yeah, so I attend overnight, she invites
Madame
me.
Beatrice?
Yeah.
Thank you, Madame Beatrice. Ciao.
Madame Beatrice invites me for the overnight. I attend the overnight, and during the overnight, we have the session of testimony, right? If God has done wonders for you, why don't you testify? So if God enabled me to come back from
the trauma
hospital, and I write papers, and I feel like I've passed.
Man, I'm still wondering that energy you have.
So I go and testify. You see, the Bible says they overcame the devil
by the power of the testimony.
The pastor gets concerned about my story. I think the way people are going to get concerned about my story. I think the way they are interested, because some of them are online. pastor just pours anointing oil on me. Pastor prays for me. You know, pouring before I was waiting for anointing oil.
I think he was moved by what you shared.
Yes. So then the pastor told me, do you have any challenges? I said, now, God.
This is the chance.
I tell the pastor, there's a problem there. I have a date of functional fees this year one up to year four. Say that one is sorted.
Wow.
God has sorted that one. Any other? I say, pastor, there's another date for hostel fee. The
how were they allowing you to be in hostel without you paying?
I was even in government hostels. You remember Kulu?
Yes. How did you enter there?
That's
you're spending time there. You are not paying because he didn't have the money to pay. How? Being in a government hall, you feed on the government food. So I think the food was catered for.
The food I had my uncle. Mm-hmm. My uncle had a wife who has a bigger position on the other side. And he would give me food for the whole semester, not for the whole semester, the rest of the 2 years.
Wow.
Since year 12 to year 4.
Miracles still happen. They still do. So if you're struggling at campus, please be hopeful. Like Nico was. This guy, I always saw him in good mood, in good... Like, he was a jolly person. I didn't know he was going through all this. Guys, I'm learning something from him. I know, though we need to share with people what we are going through, but not that at all times that people will give us solutions. Sometimes you need to cry to your maker. He knows what he designed you to go through. I think that's what exactly he was saying. Now he has an opportunity. He's getting an opportunity, someone to pay his debt.
So the church...
people will feel you a witch because the way things are happening to you.
Now the pastor says that one is sorted. Any other, I say hostel. Say that one is also sorted. Tomorrow, the pastor gave me Papa Living World Assembly. And tomorrow he says, come tomorrow and meet my admin. The next day I go meet the admin. The admin tells me, go to the pastor's office, get, they call it bank statement or a statement that shows you have debts from year one. I did that.
I know. Would you fail?
You would Erin, at I least did walk that as fast as possible. As fast as possible. I get that statement, I take.
Did so you sleep that night?
Yeah, I slept. I slept. I took it there. They processed after 1 week. Just 1 week. Stuff is cleared. Come for your acknowledgement letter that says your man has been banked on your account. I said, I got one.
The way things are happening, most of you don't believe that things happen. So you rush to Sembu Illuminati. Some of you are going to call him a witch, but he's not a witch. He's a hopeful man. Every time you're hopeful, positive things fall into your circle.
Yes.
Wow.
So everything
is clear now.
And I'm waiting for Team 10.
The only thing remaining is graduation.
Graduation.
So, do they make for you parties in the Madhvan? Because they are putting their money. They should celebrate with you. They should celebrate your success. Because all they wanted for you is to be successful. Now that you've reached the target, did they throw you some parties?
Not really. They never threw me the party, but still, I was in touch with them. The admin, those who helped me, I would go for a night of wonders overnight. I pray. I would get in touch with them. And the journey starts from there now. I graduate. Of course, you can't fail to raise this little money now.
Yes, really? Too little? You are, so even if it means college,
I find myself intent. I find myself celebrating. Like, wow. Now,
you graduate.
I tell God now, the next battle is a job.
A job. First, pause there. What was your class, if you don't mind sharing with us?
Yeah,
all the trouble he has gone through, the trauma, the suffering, and... What we want to know, how did you perform?
I had a first class from year one up to year two. When I got that trauma, I declined a little bit, but I had the final CGPA of 4.19.
Wow.
And that was
the class
upper Dean's List.
You were better than me. I got 4.07. You were better than me by 0.4. I got 4.07 and also second class upper Dean's List.
Put it super because it's a hard work.
It is a hard work.
Putting your name on the Dean's List. Wow, thank you.
I'm even buying him a cup of tea for that.
Thank you.
To congratulate him ever since he graduated. So, you're done?
So I'm done. I tell God I need a job.
You're now at Uncle's place? Where
no, I'm staying with a friend. That friend is called Julius.
Ah, Julius, you know, Kubango, you work, be a friend in need to Mwela Bidanga, Mufuna sent and Mwela Bidanga Chaliba, Mwela Matobana. About Olava Nico, I've even shared it on my channel before. But never forget all those people who have, maybe they didn't support you financially, but they did something in your life that pushed you forward. Never forget such people. So, Julio, Mwana, Tatuja Kwela, Maja Tugenda Tikova, Nai Julio Tikurina.
So, I stay with Julius, and this man is prayerful. He's working with Still and You, but prayerful, supporting me, feeding me.
Were you studying with him?
No.
How did you get to know Julius?
From church.
Oh, from church.
From church. Okay. Kakumba Chapel. That's where we connected.
This guy is social, you guys. He's social. If you're in engineering department, Chambogo University, you must have known him.
Yeah.
Even now he's out, but he still does things inside. Yeah. He connects, brings people together.
I'm a motivation speaker, wow. I'm an encourager to these young people.
Wow.
I tell them a little bit of my story, they learn from me. And I'm always in bigger gigs at university, I always go for them. I'm meeting, they call me for workshops, I attend.
Wow.
And I inspire the young
people. That is wonderful. This is Africa. Good morning. Thank you for joining us. We are with a young man. He's a brand ambassador for one of the biggest scholarship schemes in Uganda. And he's sharing his story, how he got to know the scholarships and what he went through. We are learning a lot from his experience. Thank you for joining us. So, you've done graduation. Did you have a party? And who would make for you a party?
Having a party? I was a data clerk part-time. I would raise a little bit of money in BAM Shopping Center in Bali.
Okay.
So I would raise a little bit of money. But it doesn't need a lot of money. And during that holiday, you know, from May to December.
You had accumulated some money.
I'd accumulated some money to make myself a party, to make myself memorize, to have a good
celebrate.
Live only that. There's one, my friend of mine who was working with Ministry of Works and Transport. He's called Mr. Wanyama David.
Wow.
Made the party happen.
For you?
Yes.
You man, you're blessed.
For me and my friends. He made the party happen. And we had a good time.
That is wonderful. Thank you. Me, I never had a party.
Me, I had.
Wow.
Through my friend Kule Simon, Mr. Wanyama David, we made it happen. We made it happen.
By the way, even Kule Simon, I'm soon hosting you on my channel. I'll be sharing this stream with you. I think he's busy. He didn't join us, but he joins me once in a while. He'll be saying, thank you for being so much supportive to my ninja here. He's a very social man. And Teddy's saying, well done, guys.
Thank She's you. Watching. Thank you, Teddy. Thank you so much.
She works in Protea Hotel, but she told me, I told her, I'm hosting someone from Madhvan Scholarships. And she's like, I really want to listen. I want to know about it. Maybe she has children or sisters who will benefit from this. Thank you for sharing your story. So, what would you put?
So, I finished up the party and the journey now starts as a man.
The real hustle. You're not a boy anymore.
No.
You have to feel.
The real hustle starts. Be like, God, I need a job now. I attend overnight. I pray. We pray with Julius in the house. I'm ever in Kakumba overnight. I'm ever in ministry. Chaplain Kakumba, that Reverend Engineer Emmanuel Mwesiko, supports me so much. We pray together. I do ministry. And after graduation, Monday, graduation is on 14th, Friday.
I graduated on 15th, Friday.
Graduation is on 14th, Monday, Friday. Monday, I'm called for an interview at Kakira Sugar Works.
Wow. Wow. He graduates on Friday and he's called for an interview on Monday. Let's see what people are saying. Being Sharon is like, I missed that story. I got a call and she's feeling so bad about it. But you rewatch the entire thing and you learn from him. Nicholas, never give up always. Massive respect for believing, for committing and working for what you want. More life and wisdom. That's how we grind.
Thank you so much, Peter. Thank you, Peter. That's why I put on never give up.
He's putting on a shirt. never give up.
I rarely give up.
Yes. And this is his his business. He's a very venturous man. He's a hardworking man. He is social and he's good, honestly. So
they called me for an interview. I had an interview with a workshop manager. In Kakira, he's a London guy.
About Kakira. Is it under also the Madhvan group of companies?
Yes. Madhvan has thousands of companies. Very many.
Wow.
It has a steel company, East African packaging, it has a tea factory. It has Kakira Sugars being the scent of everything.
Wow, that's where you get money to sponsor all those.
Very many.
Mm.
Mm. So I do the interview. They tell me you've gone through.
or maybe you even thought I'll go through because I've been their kid, they've educated not me, they'll really, not need me to nation that
not
speaks.
Really, they were testing my brain. They were testing, do I have that capability for the job?
Okay.
They were testing, do I have the ideas to do that job? It wasn't a free, it wasn't a mere say that you were on our scholarship, you've gone to the mall. So I do the interview. They tell me the HR is out of the country. Wait until, come back like after 1 week.
So did you come from Julius's place to go and do those interviews?
Yes.
From Kampala?
From Kampala.
To Jinja?
Yes.
Okay.
So I do the interviews. After the interviews, I wait.
Mm.
In the process of waiting, Ronnie, the managing director, East African Packaging, calls me.
It is also part of the Madhvan Group of companies.
This is Madhvan.
You man, they are all our blessings.
It interacts.
You took all our blessings. They are all in your way. They are all in your way. Brandy Ted is like still here and you're so inspiring. Habib is like, I'm one of the beneficiaries. Wow.
Wow.
You have a beneficiary
wow,
here.
That's
I'm
good.
One of the beneficiaries and I'm so proud now. Amazing construction manager.
Wow.
Habib, Viva. Thank you for sharing. Wow. You see the smile on his face? He's happy to see someone he knows. So let's share our story before we lose the light.
Wow.
I'm happy that you have an OG here.
Wow, Habib, good to see you.
Habib, is it lady or man?
Habib, Viva. I am
Habib. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Uh-huh.
Mm. So, Ronnie Madhvan, Managing Director, East African Packaging, calls me in his office for an interview.
How did he get to know you?
Best students.
Oh, best students.
Yes.
Okay.
They have your records. We have many who are employed. Not only me, very many. Bernard is in their office there.
Wow.
I have an accountant in Marasa.
Wow.
I have very many.
Wow.
Very many that are employed with Madhvan. When you perform well, Erinah, the rest
the
is
doors easy. Open.
The doors just open.
Uh-huh.
Had a good CGP, had performed very well. So Ronnie calls us, Ronnie Madhvan. Calls me and the other team for the interview. We do the interview, we go to the factory. We also do the interview. They wanted what they call maintenance mechanical technician. We do those ones, we go through. We start the job.
Oh my. So did they call you when the other human resource came back for Kakira?
They did, but I'd taken up an offer. And in their role, when you're signing those contracts with them, you can be transferred.
Anywhere
in the Madhvan Group of companies. So they told me there's no need to worry. That maybe I need to go back
to the other side. Yeah.
Yeah. They told me this is Madhvan. We can shift
you anywhere as long as you're inside the system.
Yeah. So I remain at East African Packaging. And currently, that's where I'm working.
So let me ask, how do you become a brand ambassador for Madhvan?
Wow. Well, I'm an ambassador of Madhvan because they selected me because of the history. You've seen the journey.
The story, the inspiration. Because an ambassador, I think you tell your story and it has to touch people.
And touch people and you preach out. And I've impacted many. I can't count them, but there are very many that
Amen.
Have gone through my hands.
That is
there are very many. Now the current list that came out.
Yeah.
It had 44 Madhvan Scholarship Chamboko. I had 7 through my hands.
That is wonderful.
Scratch.
But do you know most people, what I've seen in Uganda and in Africa, when someone gets such a big opportunity, they don't want to support others. They are like, I don't want them to be like me. Maybe they want to be the only big bulls in the kraal. But it's very wonderful if you got the opportunity and you're sharing it with others. Thank you so much. So how did they choose you to be the ambassador?
And I was telling you, being that story, being a motivation speaker, being have created an impact to the many. That's why I repeat, and even they chose me to... During the launch, due to work schedules, I allocated someone to be there for me. And they were there, both the former president of the scholarship and the former vice president of the scholarship.
Okay.
And what I also need to tell the public, when you work hard, you see, compared to all other scholarships, Erinah, you wouldn't believe Madhvan gives jobs. And you would think it is giving the job. Because let me clear out the air. Giving you the job, they're going to chop their money. No.
Yeah, that's what I was going to ask you, that maybe they're giving you a job, they tell you, we would give you 700K, but we shall be chopping 300K.
No, I'm clearing out this air because I'm part of the system now.
Okay.
You bargain your salary on the potential ground that I'm earning in here. I deserve this.
You deserve this. Yes. But can't you be lenient because they took you to school?
They know you're going to create an impact to the world. You may pay me that salary, but if would you know that I'm also helping someone in the village?
Oh.
Would you know that I'm using part of my money or part of my salary to help someone in the village to do what I am?
Wow.
So they just pay your money in a potential. If you're an engineer, they pay you according to the salary structure.
Of an engineer.
They don't
wonderful.
Chop any of your money.
Wow. This is beautiful. This money has been blessed all the way through, from the beginning to the end. He is now the brand ambassador, Madhvan. Are there any privileges of being a brand ambassador?
Of course.
Any privileges you are enjoying? Tell us if you have allowances, you'll be the one to buy me juice tomorrow.
No. If I'm called to talk on a gig, I represent
the Madhvan.
I market the scholarship. And do you know when you market the scholarship? Do you know many people? You know how many people
so you're looking at building social capital.
Yes. So if I'm marketing my brand, then me, if I start my fashion and design,
have many people to reach out to.
Yes, because you see, Erinah, when you're chosen a leader, it's God given.
Yeah.
You may be a leader. You remember I served as the overseer to Mesa. I served as the general secretary to Mesa. I wasn't paid, but I can use this certificate
you were
somewhere.
Serving, yes.
If you're applying, say, for a master's scholarship, they want this. You've been a leader.
They want those scholarships. Those, you know, I've never picked my certificate from this guy, Alexander.
They are there.
Alex, I'm coming for my certificate.
They are there.
I was the chief whip of the, I was the year 4 representative of the Chamboko University Mechanical Engineers Association. So I'll be coming for my certificate. This is Africa. He's like, he got a new car. Wow. So, how is everything? Before, let me ask you a very important question, because he's taken us through his story. We are now at him being a brand ambassador. We know a lot of things in campus. He's a very social man. He's a wonderful man. You would definitely want to be close to him. So we want to ask, during campus, did you like see someone? Like, you know, campus has beautiful girls. So we want to know that other part of your life, because some of us may be crushing on you right now because your wallet is seeming to be smiling. So we need to know, is there someone feasting on your wallet or tell us?
Yes, mm-hmm. I got that someone when I was in
here. So you're married?
Not yet married.
Okay.
Dating.
Dating. Let me get the phone closer so that you don't lie to us. Let us get this information firsthand. If you're married and we have lost you already, ngatweso tinga. How is that?
It's okay.
It's okay?
Yeah, I'm dating.
You're dating?
I started dating when I was in Yatu.
So
and I've been with that someone for 5 years.
Some girls are loving, they are strong and they are caring. This guy had problems. He was poor and broke. I'm not imagining, because campus are
girls.
You know,
I used not to even dress.
He used to have one t-shirt. No, doesn't change him much. So such a girl must love you deeply. Must be loving. What did you lie to them? You were broke. You could not afford to take them out. You could not afford a decent dinner or buy them gifts. That is what used to entice most of the girls I used to see at campus. They used to be enticed by those girls. So, what? We are using a phone for light, guys. So, what did you tell her? What attracted you to her?
I think
so. We are now digging into a little bit of his private life, though we are not going to go too much into it, but we definitely need to know. So what attracted you to
her? One, I wanted someone who would encourage me since I lost my...
But we were there, your friends. You never told us your things. We would encourage you. Did you need a girlfriend?
Okay. One of the things mom used to encourage me, that I need to get someone who is educated, that's one, when she was still alive. But yeah, she was still alive. So she would want to say, Nicholas, I need to see someone in your life. I'll be like, mom, why?
Even when you're at school.
Because I'm grown up.
Most parents tell us, Sagala bin to be a kazi in Gwalipo.
No, high school.
Soma, baby, like soma.
In high school, I never dated. Sinyafa, I never dated. P7, I never dated. I started dating
even nursery.
At university. Even nursery.
This day, super dating nursery.
So I started dating in year 2. We have been together since 2014 up to 2019. Those are 5 years we are still together.
5 years. Wow. You lady.
And she's called Queen Esther.
Queen. This guy, do you know why I asked that question? I always go check his status. Yes, he's always with some lady there. This one calls himself King. Is it her name?
I got the name. I got the name from the Bible. She's called Mirembe Esther. So the name Esther. If you read the Bible, the book of Esther,
she became a queen. So you are the king.
That queen in the book of Esther. Her story is like that one.
Wow.
So patient, never demanding, never stressing, so supportive.
Maybe she was
prayerful, not rich.
Because for us poor people, we are so demanding. We have a lot of problems. You know the problems. You have been poor before. You know the problems. Oh, she's the one calling. I thought she was the one calling. Wow. It is so. And I hope. Because omuntu yenna akubeeredde wo mu mbeera eno asaana okwebaza. We thank you, Esther. I've always seen you. You definitely mean a lot to Nico. I've always seen you in his status, and I sometimes ask him, but you go slow ahead on some people's daughters, and he's told me no devyange byatereera. So Esther, thank you so much for being there for my ninja. And Carl Peter, your ninja here, is saying this is great charity for hardworking and gifted students facing difficulties paying for their university studies. Yes, and we are glad, as we were chatting here, there was another beneficiary in our audience. Thank you so much for sharing. Thank you, Madhvan, for being a great soul, a great joy to people. Because by supporting one person like this, you know, in African community, Nico, one person supports like 8 people. So by supporting one person, you've supported 8 people, and each of those 8 people has another group they are supporting. So Madhvan is supporting the entire nation. Thank you so much for sharing. Esther, thank you for being a wonderful friend to Nico. I appreciate you so much. I know about you, and I'm soon, when I need to host.
And she's supporting me doing the master. She's not worried me going outside the country for my master.
Sure.
Yes.
Some people would be like, hey, what if he goes, he
she's
will
not.
See.
She's saying, honey, sweetheart, go for it.
What of her? Why
I want
you,
to be a doctor, I want to be a professor. I want to...
Why not her?
Her? She also has her passion. So, I may
no,
not
but
know.
What
I,
if you go and
I may not interrupt. No. What if you... I would go after my introduction for my wedding. Of course, I made a small introduction. That's... parents are aware.
You kuchala?
No, it's not kuchala.
You went
being,
and introduced yourself as
no,
a
No, she's
boyfriend.
The one. She's the one. She told me, you need to know my village. You may think I come from a rich background. I just stay there and she comes from a poor background, but we are.
And she's such patient. When girls come to the city, they behave like goddesses, even when they have come from the deepest parts of Uganda. Guys, learn patience. Learn to wait for God to work wonders in your life. Nico's story has been so inspiring. I wouldn't want to dig so much. He's a big man. He has a private life. Me personally, Sagala Nyokugenda, in my private life, I don't know about Netegereza. I never post my private life. So for that issue, I just wanted to clear up something here. Kubanga, umutunga gwe. People like influential people. Mbade Sagala bateke yesubi. Thank you so much for sharing. So, chichicho sobulo gambo omuntu. Ochimanyi, you know very well. A lot of people are going through what you are going through. For one, I went through it, but I've never shared it out with the audience. So what can you tell someone out there, nation like you were nation, in just
a minute? I'll tell someone that you need to be hardworking, you need to be God-fearing, you need never to give up.
Never give up.
Never give up with life. No matter the situations you go through, God knows the situation you're going through. Be brilliant.
Wow.
Don't use your challenge to be a storm to your success. Let your challenge, the way it is now, a victory to my success.
Yeah, it's even prepared. You learn a lot from those things we go through. Sometimes, kale byonna tebibeera birungi, naye tuyigamu.
so ne munnaku yo yennyini gy'olina oyinsobola obeera omugumikiza wadde olimu abo bamugamba mwetemumanyi bwavu butulumi bannange waliwo ekisinga okufiirwa omuzadde omuntu n'alwala n'okulwala omwezi mulamba naye raba era neyekuŋŋanya n'akomawo and he did wonders. So his message to you is never give up. Never. See his shirt. Never ever give up. And as we are concluding this live stream, I am going to be hosting him again. How should we do it? Because he says he has a deal for me. He has a product line that he's passing on that I will not talk about now, but he wants me to be his brand ambassador. Now you are jealous. Hey, she's getting gigs. And it is a very good and beautiful gig. I'll be hosting him again.
Yeah.
And then we talk exhaustively about that. Can I be with the next time? Can we be with Queen?
Yeah.
Or you wouldn't want to put your queen to the audience? But
being,
because she's a business partner and I'm expected to be working with her, I would maybe want to have your thoughts and how you started, the hustle, what inspired you and all those things. You can explain better maybe when you can.
Yeah, she can be around because this business I'm doing, I chose to do it together with her because she has a degree like I have.
Mm.
She's brilliant.
Mm.
She has the knowledge, she has the ideas.
Mm.
So she can be around.
Wow. Wow. Thank you for sharing. Thank you, Madhvan, for bringing hope to the many children in Uganda. Abamu abana bangi baagala okusoma, naye obusobozi butono, n'abazadde bagezezzaako nga bwe kisoboka. They have sold all the treasures they have and they have been left with nothing. They have sold their pieces of land. They have went into to labor for to see that their children get the best education they can. So we appreciate you, Madhvan, your entire team and your group of companies for bringing people's hopes to life. Thank you for saving the dreams of my ninja. He's now a motivation and inspiration speaker. Peter, you've gotten a fan from here. Peter is your big fan. He says you've been so much of a big inspiration. Branita, he said you're so much of an inspiration. Brand ambassador. Yes, you see now this one. Tondo Gavanange, don't bewitch me. I'm soon to become a brand ambassador of some product line. So, J-Max, it is such a great opportunity. Thank you guys for sharing. They're appreciating you.
And I'll pass over the message as we conclude.
Yes.
Thank you, my boss, Mr. Ronnie Madhvani, for supporting me from day one, for supporting me to up I am now.
Yes.
And I wouldn't forget to tell those ones who are hustling. I'm going to share my number. Please, 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 please. Me, I'm ready to help you.
To direct them.
All the
extras. Some of them may think that because you've offered to help them, Vanegana bagala nyo bine bintu ebitali legit. Mbuko baloza lakuba kutegede o jamu isizawe mpapula. He's going to guide you through all the necessary steps because some of you miss out because you do not know what happens. He's going to be there to help you, to guide you, and to pray with you probably, and maybe inspire you in the downs you're going through, okay? He's going to be sharing his number right now.
I share my number.
It's okay. We can put it in the description or
+256
704 30 60 15.
It's on WhatsApp.
Any other thing you need to know about my Madhvan scholarship, contact him on that number. I'll be putting it in my description box. And let me ask, do they only sponsor in local universities or even in international universities?
And they haven't reached that level. They are supposed to be Ugandan
universities. Local universities. Oh, J-Max is like, please add it in the description box. They say, but you can't broke the man, then too bad man of that to be responsible. I'm not getting your statement, Spring Garden, but you can't be broke the man, then too bad man of that. Spring Garden, I failed to get what you were saying. I think he's saying, yes, you could be broke, but then you're responsible. That is what he was trying to mean. Thank you so much for sharing your story.
And thank you for hosting.
I am very happy.
I'll be privileged.
I have learned a lot.
Extension.
Yes. Thank you so much for sharing. Guys, we are ending the live stream and I'm going to request each and every one of you. Thank you, Spring Garden, for sharing our stream on your community tab. I appreciate. And I'm going to ask you, if you're in Uganda, share this link to all the people, all the groups you know, people could definitely benefit from these scholarships. Thank you for following us up. Let me see if I missed asking you anything. Do they sponsor masters and PhD?
Yes, they do sponsor masters.
Where?
Any university.
How do I apply?
You want to apply?
Yes.
I'm here to guide you.
Guys, I am here on my way to my masters. In what? I would want to do a master's in leisure management.
Let's go first, science.
Oh, sciences. Okay.
We need doctors.
I think I'm smelling a master's in mechanical engineering. So Peter Kalmukama is like, we have to be individuals able to perceive the path to our nation's future and only traveling the road, but also not only traveling the road, but also actively participating in their development.
Thank
and
you,
this
Peter.
Is what the nigga is doing. Peter, see me.
Thank you, Peter.
Thank you, Peter. Thank you, Peter. And this is Africa's like, Erinah, your streams are very raw. Thank you. I like raw things. I don't like faking. I like sharing. I like being in a position where I can help someone in the best way I can. And this is the best we could do with Nico. And we have another one for you next time. Thank you, This is Africa, for always supporting my live stream. And big up, This is Africa. Then Bernice is like, even if university is out of Uganda, no, they are for now in the universities within Uganda. For universities out of Uganda, they are not yet on the scheme. But if you want to do a master's, they also have an opportunity. Do they only give master's to people who have been in the bachelor's scheme before?
No.
Open.
You can be, it's open.
Okay.
You can be, you've never been on the scholarship, but you can be scholarship.
Wow. It's because Nico is a wonderful man. He can talk till morning. This man talks. But what cut us short is the lighting, because you can see right now our lighting is not so good. We are using a phone to give you lighting so that you're able to see us. But thank you for enduring all the bad lighting for now and for being with us. Let's stay for 4 more minutes and make it 1 hour and 30 minutes. Can you believe we've been streaming for 1 hour and 26 minutes? Your story has been so wonderful. So where do you see yourself in 5 years from now?
5 years? I see myself being a CEO.
Wow, of what? So you're going to run away from someone who paid your school fees?
No, not running
guys,
away. It's a privilege. I'm still working. That man has a PhD, so I'm still a child.
Learning, yeah.
A learning child before him.
Wow.
Yeah, Ronnie Madhvan, I promise I'll work with him. I'll help him with attain the best dreams you want for the company.
When I buy gadgets, I'm going to buy my camera, my tripod, and my old equipment. You'll see me in your office. I'll be interviewing your boss.
Thank you.
Wow. So that you can tell us more of how they got this vision. How did they start this scholarship? Did they also suffer? Their forefathers, did they suffer? Then they are like, oh, we shall also help someone who has gone through this situation. A lot of things inspire such big projects, you know? And
Madhvan has existed in Uganda for the last 50 years.
50 years. Wow.
And was started by their father, who died. He was called Madhvan.
So it's the sons running it. Right. Do you know, a lot of people can deviate from what their fathers started. But if they are still carrying on the spirit, they are wonderful people. Thank you for being so supportive, for making and giving light to the dreams of Ugandans. We appreciate you. I can't appreciate enough. Do you know why I'm appreciative? Because I know I have a ninja who is doing well. Every time you have friends who are not doing well, you're in trouble. Do you know that?
Doreen has come in saying, hi, Erinah.
Doreen Kwesi, guys, like, hi, Doreen, you've missed an inspiring story of a young man. Please endeavor to rewatch. And anything you want to know about Madhvan Foundation, share the stream and let people contact him, because he has shared his contact all through the live stream. Please, share to everyone. Don't let anyone miss out on their dreams because of situation. Madhvan scholarships are legit. No corruption, no favoring. If you qualify, you get it. Brani Teddy is like, you're creative, Tia. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Brani Teddy.
So to basibule ndo waza tubula eda chike, mwina choyagalo gamba?
Chinjagalo gamba, kanzeko mu Luganda, right?
Yogero Luganda. Oli mochi niko na yetu, shokoleko. He's called Macho Brian Nicholas,
I know 7 languages.
7 languages?
Yes.
Uh-huh. English?
You want me to count all of them?
Yes.
English?
Mm-hmm.
Luganda. Kiswahili. Lusoga. Usamia. Luganda.
Uganda, you finished?
I finished Uganda.
Mm-hmm.
Good year.
Mm-hmm.
This one from West.
Nyankole.
Nyankole, I guess.
Wow, you're such a gifted man. Because he's social, that's how he learns all things. And one thing I've learned from Nico, he doesn't put money first. He treasures social capital. God first for him, then human. In pursuit of money. But him, he has learned the secret of his success has been in people, because it's the people he has been relating with who connected him to bigger gigs. Okay? You could learn something. Doreen Kwesiga is like, yeah, I have joined. This is Africa. It's like 7. My wife knows 6. Omanyi, 7 languages. His wife is Kenyan. She knows 6 languages. And Peter Kalis, his story describes very self-confidence. In lesson 3 of Law of Success in 16 lessons, Napoleon Hill, it's a great book. This is the book. Peter, awesome, yeah.
Thank you, Peter. You've made my evening a perfect
telling
one.
His story describes self-confidence. In lesson 3 of Law of Success in 16 lessons of 1928 by Napoleon Hill, it's a great book to everyone. He's just met Kalango. And guys, you can check that out. This is Africa. Yeah, Gambia. Many languages, Bidi.
I know.
Thank you for being with us.
Bye-bye. Catch you next time.
Next time,
subscribe to
Erinah TL.
Wow.
Are you hoping to start your channel? Or he was asking me some time back about channel.
Maybe first, and the fashion, and the channel too.
He has a lot of things, and I will definitely be bringing him back some other time. But we appreciate your presence today. Share this link even after the stream so that a lot of people can get to know about the Madhvan Scholarships and Foundation. Tabawa yo crash. Nari manize baba ita ne baba lila sende. Kwa atagendo sobe. Kwa atagendo sobe. Tabawa crash. Abatia. Thank you guys for following us. We are ending the stream. Celebrating Life has just joined us right now.
Wow.
Use one emoji. You've missed the uninspiring story of this young man. Go and rewatch it on my entire channel. It's been so motivating, so inspiring, and it builds you up. It's what you need to hear. Thank you so much. Great success stories have been stories of great failure. And it's what he is. He's a successful young man, but he's gone through a lot of hassles and trouble and trauma at the same time. Thank you for being with us. Ciao.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.